Imagine your phone battery is at 1%. No charger, no power bank, and hours to go, right when you have to make the most important call of your life. That's what using a lot of blood quickly does to your body. It drains the energy so much that organs begin to fail. But what if we could keep the power running longer? Hi, I'm Guillaume Hoareau. I'm an associate professor with emergency medicine and an investigator at the Cardiovascular Research and Training Institute. I am from a tiny dot in the Indian Ocean called Reunion Island. Our motto, Florebo quocumque ferra, which means I will flower wherever I'm carried, has guided me through pursuing my dream of becoming an emergency and critical care veterinarian. I went to veterinary school in the south of France, in Toulouse. I completed my internship at the University of Pennsylvania and a residency in emergency and critical care at the University of California, Davis. Here I'm teaching a student in my residency and taking care of a critically ill dog in my residency. On the left, I'm entering my PhD, studying the bulldog as a model of sleep apnea. Life took an unexpected turn to a PhD at Travis Air Force Base, a key hub for medical readiness. I was drawn to high-stake, fast care, and nothing reflects this more than battlefield medicine. What drove our mission really was the idea of survivable casualties, preventable death. What those are warfighters that could have survived with timely care. And from previous conflicts, we know that the vast majority of those casualties were due to hemorrhage, serious blood loss. Specifically, injuries to the chest and abdomen because bleeding could not be controlled by applying pressure. Hemorrhage due to injuries to the extremities or junctional injuries where the limb connects to the torso were more easily addressed with readily available technologies. And to this day, torso injuries remain a critical challenge. At Travis, I joined Austin Johnson's laboratory. What we studied was inserting a catheter in the aorta, the largest vessel in our body. At the tip of the catheter, there is a balloon that can be inflated to stop blood flow to the injury. Now, blocking the largest artery in our body may seem extreme, but it's a life-saving move. It stops blood flow to the injury and preserves blood delivery to the brain and the heart. And it has saved lives both on the battlefield and in civilian trauma care. I came to the University of Utah in 2020 in the emergency medicine division within the surgery department. The division was on the verge of becoming its own department, so they were boosting their research effort. I was also struck by the strong support for early career faculty and the commitment to innovation and development of new therapy to ultimately improve patient outcome. I knew that mechanical interventions alone would never be sufficient to solve the issue of severe blood loss. Even if we stop bleeding, despite our best resuscitation efforts, patients can still spiral down because their cells have lost energy and sometimes beyond repair. So I turned my attention toward the core unit of our body, the cell. Here we are looking at an animation of a cell and all of its components, and specifically in red, my new passion and research focus, the mitochondria. They are the powerhouses of the cell producing energy that fuels our body. And the idea here is that by preserving the mitochondria, could we protect the organs, much like restoring a drained phone battery? My first study here at the University of Utah tested a molecule that acts as a scaffold, not for a building, but for mitochondria. When cells are injured, their mitochondria start to fall apart. And this molecule acts as a scaffold to keep them together, like bracing a collapsing wall. And we showed that indeed we were able to restore mitochondrial function and protect organs, indeed, recharging the drained battery. Around the same time, I was fortunate to join the VPCAT with my mentor, Mike Varner, and CTSI scale 2 with my mentor, Dr. Shaw. Dr. Shaw had discovered a molecule called GGA120K. What he had shown is that after a heart attack or myocardial infarction, when the blood clot obstructs blood flow to the heart, the body's natural response is to produce more of that GGA120K, which in turn protects the mitochondria in the heart. And this molecule is part of our body's natural response to injury. And this image really reminded me of the aortic occlusion image I showed you earlier. And this is when it clicks. Could this heart protective molecule protect the whole body after severe blood loss? And this sparked our next breakthrough study. Through ECHOL's Treadwell Foundation, we were able to show that GGA120K not only protected organs, but also provided survival benefit. And now we are in a drug development process that is supported by the Department of Defense. And we are also collaborating with a Space Medicine Innovation Laboratory from the United States Air Force. Our next development venture is developing a new mitochondrial concentrate that is shelf stable and can be injected in patients after severe injuries. Due to many, many challenges, some call it overly ambitious. I call it interesting and exciting and pushing the boundaries of what's possible. And this early stage translational work, multidisciplinary, involves Dr. Granger, who is the chair of biomedical engineering, as well as military and private sector partners, and is funded through the VPR's office, Remote and Austere Condition Grand Challenge. Now, as you know, I'm an emergency and critical care veterinarian, and we've had studies funded by Special Operation Command, and we've studied shelf-stable blood products that can be used in both military working dog and humans. And this important translational work was recognized in 2023 as best in show at the Military Health System Research Symposium. And this is a top honor that recognizes work that has high potential to impact military medicine. I fulfilled my dream of becoming an emergency and critical care veterinarian, and I proudly now stand at the intersection of military medicine, trauma innovation, and mitochondrial science. I'm still chasing the same goal, giving our patients and their cells a fighting chance. I could only do that because of my amazing and dedicated team, my partners and collaborators, domestic and foreign, as well as private sector and military, and my funding sources, and also my amazing family that is really patient with the weekend and night grant writing and manuscript editing. So, and thank you very, very much for having me here. Thank you.